Hey everyone, Alex from O'Brien here. In this video, I want to show you a really great product from BioHorizons called the SmartShape Healer. And the SmartShape Healers are anatomical healing abutments, which in most cases are going to be a lot more ideal than the traditional cylindrical healing abutments. But the really cool thing about these is that they have occlusal markings that allow them to be used in place of a scan body. And there's a couple of big advantages to combining a healing abutment and scan body into one part. First is that it reduces chair time. All you have to do is take a scan with the healing abutment in place. Traditionally, you'd have to remove the healing abutment, place the scan body, take your scan, and then replace the healing abutment. And in fact, the scan can even be done at the time the healing abutment is initially placed, so that the patient doesn't even have to come in for a separate impression appointment. And the other big advantage is that since you aren't removing the healing abutment, there's no disruption of the peri-implant tissue. And that's really beneficial in preserving the tissue health. These SmartShape Healers are available for the BioHorizons internal hex implants as well as for the newer conical implants. And there are 6 shapes available. Anterior 1 is intended primarily for the upper centrals. Anterior 2 is intended for the upper laterals and all 4 lower incisors. Mid 1 is intended primarily for the upper cuspids. Mid 2 is intended for the upper bicuspids and the lower cuspids and bicuspids. And finally, posterior 1 and 2 are both intended for the molars. Now, you can use any of these healing abutments in any position, but it is worth noting that not every shape is available for every platform size. As an example, the anterior 1 and 2 are not available for the 5.7 platform, and the posterior 1 and 2 are not available for the 3.0 platform. Each of the shapes are available in 2 height variants, the regular and the tall. And the identification markers on the top of the healing abutments provide useful information about the abutment and the implant. The dimples are what indicate the implant platform. And so, for example, on the internal hex healers, there are 3 dimples for the 5.7 platform, 2 for the 4.5, 1 for the 3.5, and finally, there are no dimples on the abutments for the 3.0 platform. In addition to the dimples, each abutment also has a notch that tells us the height of the abutment. The line notch is for the regular healing abutments, and the T notch is for the tall healing abutments. And when placing these healing abutments, that notch should always face the facial or buccal. It's also important that once the healing abutment is seated, that it is sticking out of the tissue by a minimum of 0.5 millimeters. And that'll allow the software to correctly line the scan up with the library version. The surface of these healing abutments has a matte finish, and that makes it easier for scanning. However, if you don't have an intraoral scanner, you can also take a traditional impression of the healing abutment, which the lab can then scan into the design software. Another really cool thing about these is that BioHorizons has provided STL files that mimic the entire shape of the healing abutment, including the subgingival contour. And that means we can import that shape into our design software and then adjust the final abutment to match it. A final thing to note is that you should check with your lab before using these to verify that they are set up to accept them. I hope you found this video helpful, and as always, feel free to contact us with any questions. See you next time.